Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll guide you through an overview of the AMD Versal Network on chip, NoC, and discuss key strategies for its performance tuning. We will first start with an introduction to the AMD Versal Network on chip NoC, followed by the NoC architecture and terminology. Then, we will show you how to access the Versal NoC for your designs. And finally, we will go over important NoC settings needed to achieve a desired bandwidth and latency. Let's get started. The AMD Versal Network on Chip, or NoC, is a high-speed, scalable communication fabric that forms the backbone of data movement across the Versal architecture. It provides unified device-wide connectivity between all major IP endpoints. This includes the programmable logic, the processing system, hard IP blocks like DDR memory controllers, PCIe, and the AI engine array. It operates at up to 1080 MHz and uses packet-based communication, which allows for decoupled transactions and greater parallelism. The Versal architecture fundamentally differs from previous FPGA generations in that it requires all communication with hard DDR memory controllers to go through the NoC. This architectural decision improves scalability, data integrity, and performance predictability across the device. The NoC master unit is the ingress port interface to the NoC. The NMU supports packet-based and AXI-based communication protocols as it packetizes AXI data before placing it on the NoC. The NoC slave unit, NSU, is the egress port interface to the NoC. At the NSU, data is depacketized to AXI for communication outside of the NoC. The NoC packet switch routes data between the NMUs and NSUs. Its job is to buffer and arbitrate data over physical NoC lanes. Communication is fully AXI compliant. AXI 3, AXI 4, and AXI 4 stream are supported. Understanding these components is essential for designing efficient traffic flows and minimizing contention. The configurable NoC is an AXI4-based network to route high-bandwidth, real-time, and low-latency connections. The NoC extends in both horizontal and vertical directions to the edges of the device. The multi-channel structures provide several options for routing and isolating traffic. The NoC is a full-blocking crossbar between memory controllers, programmable logic, processing system, integrated hardware, integrated peripherals, and the platform management controller. Internally, the NoC transforms these AXI transactions into a fixed-width, 128-bit packetized format. This packet-based protocol allows the NoC to route traffic efficiently across the chip using dedicated horizontal and vertical links. The ingress and egress points to the NoC are the NoC master and slave units, which provide asynchronous clock domain crossing, rate matching, and packetization from or to AXI 3, AXI 4, or AXI 4 stream protocols, and the NOC packet protocol, NPP. The horizontal NoC, HNoC channels are located at the top and bottom of the device. They sit close to high throughput peripherals like DDR memory controllers, PCIe blocks, and processing systems. The vertical NoC VNoC provides routing along the height of the chip. Devices can include up to 8 vertical NoC paths, which is determined by the die size and the number of hard blocks like DDRMCs. In Versal SSIT devices, the NoC is extended between SuperLogic regions SLRs using a NoC inter-die bridge, or NIDB. Together, the HNoC, VNoC, and NIDB form a fully integrated communication infrastructure, allowing the AMD Versal platform to scale across device families and system requirements while maintaining consistent, high-performance interconnect behavior. The AMD Versal NoC can be accessed using Vivado IP Integrator or the modular NoC RTL-based workflows. Two versions of the Versal NoC IP exist, AXI memory mapped or AXI stream interfaces. Connect the NMUs and NSUs to the PL or other Versal hard IP. For modular NoC, access the NoC IP using parameterized macros, XPM. For users implementing dynamic function exchange, DFX, please note that DFX is only supported by the modular NoC flow. NoC performance in AMD Versal devices is influenced by a combination of interrelated factors, including traffic class, bandwidth, latency, placement, competing traffic, and AXI transaction type. Traffic class determines arbitration priority, ensuring time-critical streams such as low latency or isochronous data are serviced ahead of best effort transfers when contention occurs. Bandwidth depends on how much data is requested versus the capacity of each NoC lane, while latency reflects the round-trip delay for requests and responses, both of which can be impacted by path length and arbitration delays. Physical placement of network master units, NMUs, and network slave units, NSUs, affects hop count and potential contention points, with closer placement typically reducing delay. Multiple masters targeting the same NSU create competing traffic that requires careful QoS and scheduling to prevent bandwidth starvation. Knowing these factors and their effects on NoC performance is crucial in determining NoC bandwidth and latency. QoS in the AMD Versal NoC enables reserving resources for critical data streams by assigning independent quality of service settings to each channel. These settings define traffic priority, such as low latency, isochronous, or best effort, along with bandwidth guarantees and latency requirements. By controlling these parameters, QoS ensures that time-sensitive traffic meets its delivery deadlines and prevents lower priority or high volume transfers from starving critical flows. When configuring the quality of service for a NoC master unit, each channel in the NoC master unit must have specified bandwidth and traffic priority levels to guide performance expectations. NoC design rule checks, DRCs, validate feasibility by ensuring that defined paths can meet the requested bandwidth and latency, while also detecting potential deadlocks or oversubscription issues early in the design process. It is important to note that QoS does not reserve bandwidth outright. Instead, it guarantees that a lane is capable of meeting the requirement but will not block other traffic unless necessary. The AMD Versal NoC supports three traffic classes, each designed for specific use cases. Low latency offers the highest priority for read traffic and minimizes structural delays, making it ideal for real-time control paths. Isochronous guarantees a deterministic maximum latency, which is essential for streaming video or audio data that must arrive at precise intervals. Best effort is the lowest priority class and serves as the default for background transfers or non-critical tasks. Correctly classifying traffic ensures that real-time data is not delayed or disrupted by bulk transfers, maintaining predictable system performance. In the AMD Versal NoC, bandwidth determines how much data can be moved between masters and slaves over a given path, and understanding its limits is key to meeting system performance goals. Each NoC lane is 128 bits wide, with a maximum combined read and write throughput of 34.56 gigabytes per second, though write bandwidth is slightly less efficient due to the header flits required for packetization. When higher throughput is needed, multiple lanes can be allocated by mapping network master units NMUs accordingly. Because bandwidth is also speed grade dependent, the actual achievable performance can vary between devices and configurations. In the AMD Versal NoC, read and write transactions have slightly different bandwidth efficiencies due to packetization overhead. For example, a 64-byte, 512-bit transfer requires 4 flits for a read operation, as the payload fits exactly into the 128-bit lane width. The same transfer as a write requires 5 flits because of an additional header flit, making write slightly less efficient. Understanding this packetization overhead is important for accurate bandwidth budgeting, especially since the impact is more pronounced for small burst writes than for large sequential transfers. NoC latency is influenced by both the physical structure of the interconnect and the dynamic conditions during operation. Structural latency is determined by the number of switches and hops a transaction must traverse between the Network Master Unit, NMU, and Network Slave Unit, NSU. Queuing latency occurs when there is high contention for resources or when a sync device processes data more slowly than it is received. Longer physical distances between NMUs and NSUs require more NOC resources and additional pipeline stages, which can further increase latency. Careful floor planning to place NMUs and NSUs closer together helps minimize hops and reduce overall transaction delay. As stated in the previous slide, latency will increase as the distance between NOC masters and slaves increases. Being observant of where other IP is placed on the board can help minimize the distance between NOC master and slave units. The AMD Vivado XSim simulator provides a complete environment for evaluating NOC performance, enabling you to visualize signal waveforms, measure latency, and generate bandwidth reports specific to the interconnect. Bandwidth can be captured using the AXI performance monitor within the NOC simulation and summarized in real time to show both sustained and peak throughput for different traffic classes or channels. Latency is observed in the waveform view by measuring the delay from a valid address or command to the first valid data beat, accounting for factors such as structural hops, arbitration cycles, and pipeline stages. Several NOC-specific conditions influence these results, including fall-through latency, the minimum achievable transfer time without contention, traffic patterns like burst length and address alignment, arbitration delays caused by competing flows, and congestion when multiple masters share the same resources. Analyzing these simulation metrics helps guide QoS tuning, traffic shaping, NMU/NSU placement strategies, and channel allocation to achieve predictable performance in the implemented design. In NOC simulation, the AXI Performance Monitor is a key tool for analyzing bandwidth utilization and identifying potential bottlenecks, both in simulation and during on-hardware validation. Traffic generators can be used to produce synthetic, controllable data patterns that stress specific NOC paths, allowing you to validate bandwidth, latency, and arbitration behavior before introducing real application traffic. These synthetic tests help isolate variables, making it easier to evaluate design decisions such as QoS settings, channel allocation, or NMU and NSU placement. Additional debugging tools within the simulation environment enable verification of QoS effectiveness and confirmation that latency targets are being met, ensuring that the interconnect behaves as expected under various load conditions. Introduced in the 2025.1 tools release, the NOC multi-phase feature allows time slicing of NOC traffic into defined phases, enabling different data flows to use the same interconnect resources at scheduled intervals. By segmenting transfers into predictable time windows, multi-phase operation reduces contention, minimizes latency, and improves determinism without the need to over-provision bandwidth. This approach enhances resource sharing efficiency and is especially effective for workloads with repeatable access patterns, such as AI inference pipelines, where compute stages and data transfers occur in a regular cyclical sequence. The resources listed here provide additional support for implementing and optimizing NOC-based DDR memory designs in AMD Versal devices. The Versal NOC and DDRMC Design Process Guide on the Xilinx Wiki offers in-depth explanations of memory controller setup, NOC routing, and system-level considerations. It includes detailed descriptions of interleaving strategies, address mapping schemes, and performance tuning. The Vivado Design Tutorials GitHub repository contains practical version-aligned examples for configuring AXI NOC and DDRMC blocks using simulation IPs such as the AXI Traffic Generator and AXI Performance Monitor and interpreting results from Vivado XSim. These tutorials are structured to assist both new and experienced users in deploying high-performance memory systems. These resources are recommended for initial implementation, advanced performance tuning, and validation across all stages of development.